At the outset, I would like to thank organizers for giving me this opportunity. Basically, the talk which has been given to me is GLP-1 receptor agonist as an anti-obesity drug. We know that this drug is mainly used in treating the patients for diabetes. But here, we can use this drug as an anti-obesity drug. And recently, it has been US FDA has approved this drug as an anti-obesity drug in 2021. We know that obesity worldwide has increased almost 3 times since 1975. In 2016, more than 1.9 million adults and 18 years old were obese, and it has the incidence has been increased. Of these, over 650 million were obese. 39% of adults aged 18 years and over are overweight. In 2016, and most of them are obese, almost 13% are obese. Over 340 million children and adolescents aged 5 to 19 years old are overweight. So this is the incidence of obesity, and the drugs available to treatment of obesity is...
Devgam, sir, sorry. I'm just... Dr. Arvind Iyer, please mute your mic, please. From RX event, can... Yes, thank you. Thank you so much. Sir, go on.
Yes, sir. As we know that limited drugs are available in treating the patients of diabetes, treating the patients of obesity, several drugs were come in the market, and because of their side effects, they have to go back. But initially, the drug which was approved was phentermine in 1959, and liraglutide has been approved recently in 2014 as a number 3 milligram as an anti-obesity drug. Several drugs that were initially approved were subsequently gone out of market because of its side effects. As we know that the drug which was used was initially fenfluramine, dexfenfluramine, sibutramine, lorcaserin, and recently the GLP-1 analog. The glucagon-like peptide, we know that GLP-1 is an endogenous incretin hormone. And this hormone, we know that the secretion of this hormone is dependent on the glucose-dependent secretion. So the chances of getting hypoglycemia is comparatively very less, because the higher the sugar, the secretion will be more. And it is secreted by the small intestinal L cells in the distal ileum and proximal colon after ingestion of glucose and other carbohydrates. Having a low concentration during fasting, if the blood sugar levels are less, the GLP-1 levels are also less. That means it is dependent on the glucose levels. GLP-1 receptor belong to the G protein coupled receptor family. It is mainly expressed in the pancreas and central nervous system, and also found in the heart, kidneys, blood vessels, and peripheral neurons. What is GLP-1? GLP-1 binds to its receptor, particularly pancreatic beta cells, increase insulin production in a glucose-dependent manner due to enhanced intracellular levels of cyclic AMP. It promotes survival and proliferation of pancreatic beta cells. GLP-1 inhibits glucagon secretion by pancreatic alpha cells, thereby reducing hepatic glucose production. Other biological effects of endogenous GLP-1 include slowing gastric emptying, it increasing postprandial satiety, and ultimately it reduces the food consumption because of reducing the appetite. GLP-1 influences the neurons of the paraventricular and arcuate nucleus, attenuating the orexigenic signals, and it also reduces the appetite. Main biological effects of GLP-1 are not only on pancreas, but it also has effects on liver, central nervous system, gastrointestinal system, cardiovascular system, and renal system as well. In pancreas, we know that it increases the insulin secretion, thereby reducing the blood sugar levels. It decreases the glucagon secretion, thereby reducing the blood sugar, and it stimulates the pancreatic beta cell proliferation and their survival. It reduces the liver, reduces the glucogenesis through liver, increases glycogen storage, reduces lipogenesis. In central nervous system, it reduces the appetite, thereby reducing the weight. In gut, it has slows down the gastric emptying, and it slows gastric motility as well, as it reduces the appetite in these patients, thereby helping the reducing the weight. In cardiovascular system, it reduces the systolic blood pressure. So it has got a pleiotropic effects. where it has got effects on almost all the systems. And these are all positive effects which are helping in reducing the weight also. GLP is a 30 amino acid peptide hormone. Its half-life is very low. It is 1.5 minutes following intravenous dosing. And it's 1.5 hours following subcutaneous dosing in humans. Rapid degradation of the endogenic GLP-1 is by DPP-4 enzymes. And these properties have posed challenges to the pharmaceutical use of this drug. The GLP-1 receptor agonist, given the beneficial effects of GLP-1 on glucose metabolism, its weight, there was an immense interest in developing a pharmacological compound which mimicked the action of GLP-1. The first GLP-1 receptor approved for type 2 management was synthetic exenatide 4. It was named as exenatide, and it was developed using the venom of the Gila monster lizard. Based on their pharmacological kinetics, GLP-1 receptors are classified as short-acting and long-acting agents. Short-acting are characterized by periods during which patients are exposed to the drug concentration that lasts for only few hours. These are exenatide and lixenatide. The long-acting, which produces long-lasting circulating drug concentration with minor side effect, minor duration, it is a liraglutide, which is once weekly, exenatide, dulaglutide, and albiglutide, and now it is a semaglutide. So liraglutide and semaglutide, their studies which has been already published, and it has been approved by USFDA as a weight reducing drugs. Liraglutide in weight management, body weight management, liraglutide can activate GLP-1 receptors found in hypothalamic region, thereby reducing the feeding, such as hypothalamic, paraventricular, and arcuate nucleus. In the arcuate nucleus, liraglutide stimulates the appetite inhibiting pro-opiomelanocortin hormones. It inhibits the orexigenic neuropeptide gamma, and it results with reducing the food intake and increase satiety. Liraglutide has proven its weight loss benefits in several clinical trials. These trials mainly lead to trials where body weight loss in a dose-dependent manner was noticed in the liraglutide 2.8 kilograms compared to the glimepiride group that had associated weight gain. On the contrary, the lead 5 trial, where it is the liraglutide produced significant weight loss where it was compared with the placebo treatment, and versus insulin glargine also, there is reduction, weight reduction was almost 3.43 in liraglutide group as compared to glargine, where we know that insulin glargine is known to cause weight gain rather than reducing the weight. Lead 6 trial, liraglutide 1.8 mg per day and exenatide 10 micrograms twice daily produced significant weight loss. It is almost 3.24 kg as compared to the placebo. This is a scale trial, where scale clinical trial conducted in almost 126 sites in 9 countries. Investigated the safety and efficacy of liraglutide as weight-reducing drug and excess weight individuals with type 2 diabetes mellitus in association with 500 kg per day deficit and increased physical activity. So increased physical activity and exercise, we know that this is known to help, and they have compared with liraglutide. After 56 weeks in subjects with type 2 diabetes, 3 mg of liraglutide with most weight loss was almost compared to the liraglutide 1.8 mg per day, and 6.4 kg versus 5 kg weight loss was seen. This ETD for liraglutide 3 versus placebo, it was minus 4, and for ETD for liraglutide 1.8 versus placebo was minus 2.71%. For both liraglutide, it is less than 0.001. Weight loss of 5 to 10% of body weight is associated with improved outcome of comorbidities in type 2 diabetes. Weight loss of at least 5% occurred in 54.3% patient with liraglutide 3 mg. Liraglutide as compared to liraglutide 1.8 mg, it was 21.4% compared with placebo. Reduction of at least 10% in weight loss was noted in 25.2% of cases with liraglutide 3 mg. 15.9% of patients with liraglutide 1.8 mg and 6.7% with placebo. So if you compare with the placebo, the reduction of weight loss was quite significant. ETD between liraglutide 3 mg versus placebo if P was less than 0.001, or little to 1.8 milligram, placebo it was 0.006. It was quite significant. Scale obesity, double blind trial. Scale obesity and pre-diabetes double blind trial investigated the patients with liraglutide 3 milligram per day. This was 56 weeks trial, 3,731 individuals with type 2 diabetes. The BMI of these patients was more than 30 or 27 kilograms per meter when dyslipidemia or hypertension was also associated. At 56 weeks, liraglutide treated subjects achieved a weight loss of almost 8.4%, 8.4, with a loss of 2.8 plus or minus 6.5 kg. 63.2% of subjects in the liraglutide group had a weight loss of at least 5%. And 27.1% subjects in the placebo group weight loss was almost less than 5%. Weight loss of at least 10% was encountered in 33.1% patients in liraglutide group versus placebo group. Liraglutide also showed very promising perspective in the management of obesity in individuals with under 18 years of age. In 2020, a randomized double-blind trial which investigated liraglutide 3 mg as a weight reduction option in obese adolescent patients. Liraglutide was found to be superior to placebo plus lifestyle modification, where the BMI standard deviation score was at week was 56. In 2014, US FDA approved this drug for weight loss, indicated as an adjunct to reduce calorie diet, increase physical activity, and in weight management in adult patients with an initial BMI of more than 30 kilograms per square meter or greater, that is obese patients, or 27 kg per square meter or greater in the presence of at least one or other comorbid conditions like hypertension, type 2 diabetes, or dyslipidemia. Pediatric patients with age of 12 years and older with body weight above 60 kg and initial BMI corresponding was 30. Limitations of use should not be co-administered with other liraglutide containing products or other GLP-1 receptor agonists. Safety and effectiveness in pediatric patients type 2 diabetes have not been studied. Safety and efficacy in combination with other products indicated have not been published. Dosage and administration, we know that liraglutide we are using in patients of type 2 diabetes, those patients who are obese and type 2 diabetes. It is to be injected subcutaneously in the abdomen, thigh or upper arm once daily at a time, same time, regardless of the timing of the meals. Recommended dose of liraglutide 3 mg per daily. Start the dose with 0.6 mg per day for one week. In weekly intervals, increase the dose until the dose reaches to 3 milligrams. If pediatric patient do not tolerate an increased dose during the dose escalation because of its side effects. Dose escalation for pediatric patients may take up to 8 weeks. The pediatric patients who do not tolerate 3 milligrams daily may be treated with reduced doses. Adult patients with type 2 diabetes should monitor blood glucose prior to starting the drug. Most common adverse effects reported in more than 5% are nausea, diarrhea, constipation, vomiting, and injection site reactions. Hypoglycemia is not that common. Dyspepsia, fatigue, and dizziness, abdominal pain may be there. The gastrointestinal side effects are common in this type of patient, and that is one of the commonest indications where we have to withdraw the drugs, because most commonly these side effects occur after the initiation of the drug treatment and after increasing the dose. To minimize the impact of these adverse effects, it is recommended that it should be initiated at lower dose, then slowly increase the dose weekly. Warning risk of thyroid cell tumors. Liraglutide causes thyroid cell tumors at clinically relevant exposure genders of rats and mice. The human relevance of liraglutide induced rodent thyroid cell carcinoma has been determined. Contraindicated in patients with a personal or family history of the thyroid cell tumors or multiple endocrine neoplasia syndromes. Counsel the patient regarding the potential risk of this particular side effects. Personal or family history of metabolic thyroid cell carcinoma, neoplasia, or hypersensitivity to the liraglutide or any patient's health. And pregnancy, it should not be used. Then another important drug which has been approved recently and in India also likely to get in type 2 diabetes as oral drug is semaglutide. semaglutide is approved, injectable semaglutide is approved for as an obesity drug, but oral semaglutide is yet to be approved as anti-obesity drug. These drugs are mainly tried in patients of type 2 diabetes mellitus. Semaglutide is also a GLP-1 receptor agonist with long elimination of half-life. Half-life of the subcutaneously administered semaglutide is almost 183 hours. So that is the reason why it is to be given once a week in the presence of normal kidney function. It's allowing subcutaneous administration for once a week. Approved once weekly subcutaneous semaglutide for the treatment of type 2 diabetes as well as in obesity. Weight loss efficacy of once weekly subcutaneous semaglutide appears to be compared with other once weekly GLP-1 receptor agonist. It's almost like same. Semaglutide treatment effects in patients with obesity, that is a STEP trial. It is a four phase three clinical trials that tested the drug efficacy and safety. More than 4,000 adults with overweight were treated. They were randomized to receive a reduced calorie meal plan and increased activity or the lifestyle intervention plus semaglutide. For 68-week trial of subcutaneous semaglutide, 2.4 mg per week versus placebo. Step 1 trial, Step 2, Step 3 and Step 4, February, March and 2021. So this is a recently published trial. All trials were in adults with overweight or obesity. Step 1 was in almost 1,900 patients. Step 2 was in 1,200 patients. Step 3 is almost 600 patients along with lifestyle modification. And Step 4 was in 800 patients. And after a 20-week run in, and the trial examined further weight loss in subsequent patients. In the Step 1, 2 and 4 trials of individuals with overweight and obesity, those in the semaglutide group attained a 15 to 18% weight loss after 4 weeks, and dosage was well tolerated, and most common side effect observed was gastrointestinal side effect. They were transient and mild to moderate severity. June 2021, US FDA approved these drugs for weight loss. It is indicated as an adjunct to the diet and exercise. In chronic weight management in adult patients with initial BMI of more than 30 kg or greater and 77 kg or per square meter or greater in the presence of at least one comorbid condition like hypertension and type 2 diabetes or dyslipidemia. And it should not be used in combination with other semaglutide containing prescriptions. Safety and efficacy of co-administration with other products of weight loss has been not been established and should not been studied in patients with history of pancreatitis. It also is to be administered once weekly on the same day of each week at any time with or without meals. Inject subcutaneously in the abdomen or thigh. Initiate at 0.25 milligram once weekly for weeks. In 4 weeks interval, it should be increased up to 2.4 milligram is to be reached. The maintenance dose of 2.4 mg once weekly is advisable in patients with type 2 diabetes. Monitor their blood sugar levels. Most common adverse reactions reported greater in patients were nausea, diarrhea, vomiting, constipation, and abdominal pain. The warning in rodents, semaglutide caused thyroid cell tumor, so it should not be used in such type of patients where there is a thyroid abnormality. Contraindicated in patients with personal or family history of multiple endocrine neoplasia syndromes and counsel the patient regarding the potential risk of TMC. Personal or family history of medullary thyroid cell carcinoma in patients and known hypersensitivity to the semaglutide drug. In summary, for decades, the world has been lacked in the effectiveness of pharmacotherapy of anti-obesity drug. The few available drugs have been withdrawn due to side effects. Few options were available, that is diet, exercise, and bariatric surgery. Manipulation of the physiological satiety hormone with GLP is an effective and tolerated as anti-obesity drug with additional pleiotropic beneficial effects, and it welcomed the addition to the treatment options for obesity. Thank you.